Canaanland Moores presents Common Sense Quickies.
Bruh, are you serious? Another one?
Yeah, I know. Just don't make this a habit.
Canaanland Moores presents Common Sense Longing. What we do here is we add some common sense thinking to everyday situations or comments that may arise. Wanna give it a try?
First of all, we have to apologize to all of you. Why, you may ask? Well, here at Common Sense Quickies, we pride ourselves on being as thorough as possible, leaving no cracks in the pavement for debris to get through. You see, in Common Sense Quickies number 27, titled The Meaning of More, we showed how more, M-O-O-R, came from more, M-A-U-R, and that more, M-A-U-R, was on the walls of ancient Hekupta, aka ancient Egypt, and the meaning being the title of the high priests of Anu. And this appears in An Egyptian Hieroglyphic Dictionary, Volume 1, by E.A. Wallace Budge. And when digging into the meaning, we find out that it goes back to at least 3200 BCE, which predates the Greek and Latin languages by a long shot, pretty much 1,000 years prior. And this is where the Greek and Roman languages took the title more, M-A-U-R, and added the suffix U-S to it to form morus, M-A-U-R-U-S, for Greek, and added the suffix O-S to it to form moros, M-A-U-R-O-S, for Latin, some 1,000 plus years later. If you haven't seen Common Sense Quickies number 27, The Meaning of More, please go watch it, and you shall see the full breakdown of how more does not mean black. And if you subscribe to the belief that more means black, you are literally pushing the modern European meaning. All right, so why the apology? Well, in recent times, we have been getting skeptics about the author of An Egyptian Hieroglyphics Dictionary, E.A. Wallace Budge, and that his potential ties with the Shriners means his work is quote-unquote tainted, and we should not take his work as truth. Even though, when you research what he wrote about More being the title of the High Priests of Anu, Anu is the god that is responsible for bringing all life to the planet, and the More is the High Priest of that god. So even if E.A. Wallace Budge made that up, this is some really high praise for us and our ancestors, don't you think? But for some skeptics, they would rather take the mundane meaning for moros and morus, meaning black, and run with that instead of the high priests of God. Go figure. Victim mindset, if you ask us. But I digress. Well, to all the skeptics, we must apologize for leaving this additional information out of Common Sense Quickies number 27, The Meaning of More. In 2015, I took a trip to New Zealand and Australia, and it was a great trip. I especially loved New Zealand. And at Wellington Airport, and all around the city, there is a Lord of the Rings theme that lets newcomers know that this incredible movie trilogy, as well as the Hobbit movies, all came from the creative and talented people on the small island working at the Weta Cave. And enough can't be said about our Maori brothers and sisters and how genuinely kind they are, as well as all I encountered at New Zealand. I definitely recommend it as a place to visit. When I went to the Wellington Museum, it was very interesting and informative. All the signs describing the showpieces were both in English language and Maori language, and the Maori language was displayed first. In this sign, they are speaking about greenstone, a beautiful stone from the jade family that's indigenous to New Zealand. In this sign, they are speaking about the sharp stone tools that the Maori brought with them to New Zealand. It reads, "When people arrived here, they brought a new edge to the environment, the use of sharp stone tools. For these first settlers, the forests were the realm of Tane, the deity who imbues all things with Mori, brackets life force. So, in order to use forest resources, it was necessary to seek his permission with Karakia, brackets prayers." So, in this write-up, we learned that in the Maori language, the word Mori means life force. And if you check the image that I showed you before, Mori also means spiritual essence, which, if you think about it, your spiritual essence is your life force. So now, of course, we need to check when approximately did the Maori language originate. First, let's go to Etym Online and read what it says about our Maori brothers and sisters. Maori, noun, Polynesian inhabitant of New Zealand. 1843, native name said to mean normal, natural, ordinary, of the usual kind, as an adjective by 1849. Now that's really interesting. As an adjective by 1849. But let's not go down that rabbit hole. So according to Etym Online, the Maori are Polynesian. Second, let's go to the New World Encyclopedia website and read what they have to say. Maori. The word Maori refers to the indigenous people of New Zealand and their language. Both the term and the people are a hybrid of various Polynesian cultures and are thought to have arrived in New Zealand more than 1,000 years ago. Now let's move down to Maori origins. It is thought that New Zealand was one of the last areas on Earth to be settled by humans. Archaeological and linguistic evidence suggests that probably several waves of migration came from eastern Polynesia to New Zealand between 800 and 1300 CE. Maori origins relate to those of their Polynesian ancestors. So, with all this talk about Polynesian, of course we have to check out Polynesia. Now let's scroll down to history. Second paragraph. Maternal mitochondrial DNA analysis suggests that Tongans, Samoans, Niueans, Cook Islanders, Tahitians, Hawaiians, Marquesans, and Maori are genetically linked to indigenous peoples of Southeast Asia. Between about 3000 and 1000 BCE, speakers of Austronesian languages spread from Taiwan into the edges of Western Micronesia and on into Melanesia. So here, in the history section of Polynesia, it says that the Maori language goes back to between about 3000 and 1000 BCE. Now let's read what Wikipedia has to say. Maori people. The Maori are the indigenous Polynesian people of mainland New Zealand. Now let's scroll down to the history section. Origins from Polynesia. No credible evidence exists of pre-Maori settlement of New Zealand. On the other hand, compelling evidence from archaeology, linguistics, and physical anthropology indicates that the first settlers migrated from Polynesia and became the Maori. Evidence indicates that their ancestry as a part of a larger group of Austronesian peoples stretches back 5,000 years to the indigenous peoples of Taiwan. Polynesian people settled a large area encompassing Samoa, Tahiti, Hawaii, Easter Island, and finally New Zealand. And so, 5,000 years ago was 3000 BCE. And the Wikipedia page ties into what was written on the New World Encyclopedia website, where it said that the Maori language goes back to about 3000 BCE. And 3000 BCE predates both Greek and Latin, doesn't it? Let's check. If we go to the Proto-Greek language page, which is the parent language of Greek, and Greek being the parent language of Latin, and we scroll down to the origins, it says that Proto-Greek originated in 2400 BCE. So that means that the Maori language predates Proto-Greek by 600 years. And that also means that the Maori definition for Mori, meaning spiritual essence, and Mori, meaning life force, also predates the Greek and Latin definition for Morus and Moros, respectively, meaning black. So for those that choose not to trust the Egyptian Hieroglyphics Dictionary, Volume 1 by E.A. Wallace Budge, and the definition for Mor, M-A-U-R, he has written in the book, because supposedly he was a Shriner. The Maori language predates both Greek and Latin languages by at least 600 years. And the definition for Mori in the Maori language means spiritual essence and life force.
And we are willing to bet that there are more positive definitions for Mori in our Maori brothers and sisters' beautiful language. And we are also willing to bet that none of those definitions mean black. So, you can reject the Egyptian Hieroglyphics Dictionary, Volume 1, and its definition of Maor, M-A-U-R. But our Maori brothers and sisters have this word in their vocabulary, dating back to roughly the same time of 3200 BCE, when it is said that the word Maor, M-A-U-R, at the very least, goes back to and appears on the walls of ancient Hecupta.
And once again, we apologize for not bringing this information to you sooner. We just thought that the Egyptian Hieroglyphics Dictionary would be enough. But apparently for some, it wasn't. Go figure.
Common sense was made before book sense.